Hi, Tappers. Are you ready to learn the weirdest technique in EFT? Even though it may look odd, it is one of the most effective ways to drop a sud score, especially if the person is overwhelmed or if you've been tapping and your score hasn't gone down. In fact, the data shows that it is successful even when nothing else with EFT works. It's called the nine gamut, and some call it the clock technique. If you are going to formally do the technique, it has nine steps. Sometimes it works to use only a few steps, but we'll get to that. Before we jump into how to do it, hear this. Do not rush it. You will want to. You will be tempted to. You will do it by accident. Do not rush it. You will cut yourself short of a lot of the effectiveness that you can gain if you just go through the motions. And this technique is something you do when you feel stuck or overwhelmed, so you may want to really check out of it or not really care about how it's going. Be as present as possible and don't rush it. That is when the magic happens. Of course, by magic, I mean scientifically based, neurologically trackable, clinically tested outcomes. Let's break down the steps and see what they do. For the entire sequence, tap on this point on your hand, known as the gamut point. It is in between your bones for your pinky and your ring finger. Either hand is fine. Steps 1 and 2, close your eyes and open your eyes. This ensures you are in the present moment. Steps 3 and 4, while keeping your face straight forward, look down hard to the left, back forward, down hard to the right, and back forward. There are several steps that involve eye movement. It has been proven that how the eyes move during a thought or a memory affects how it is stored in the brain. By bringing the trigger up and consciously shifting the eyes in certain patterns, you can shift how the brain processes that memory and releases it as a trigger. Sounds crazy, feels crazy to do, but feels crazy good when you try it and it works. Moving on. Steps 5 and 6. This is the meat of the process and why it's nicknamed the clock technique. Keeping your face straight forward. Look up with your eyes only to the periphery of your vision. Let's call this the 12 on a clock. Now circle your eyes down to 3 o'clock, down to 6 o'clock, 9 o'clock, and finally back up to 12 o'clock. You want to go slow and controlled, though you may notice your eyes skipping certain areas. We'll talk about that in a second. Do several rotations in this direction, then switch to the other direction. If your eyes ache or you feel dizzy, pause and allow your eyes to rest. This is due to your muscles being used in an unfamiliar way, and it will resolve after a few rounds. When your eye skips a space, it is thought that that is a helpful place to iron out the trigger, so take some time to go back and forth on that area. Once your eyes are fairly smooth in both directions, you are ready to move on to the next step. Step 7. Look straight ahead and hum 2 bars of any song. Humming resets and tones the vagus nerve, which is a huge nerve connected to every system in the body and nearly every organ. It is controlled by the autonomic nervous system and highly reactive in fight or flight. Humming is very helpful to calm any response you are having with your trigger. Step 8. Count out loud to 5. This engages the brain in a different way due to what is lit up, focusing on counting, and engaging as many neural pathways as possible is a goal in EFT to help release those traumatic connections. And step 9, hum again. After you have completed the entire process, check back in on your sud score. It likely will be much less than it was only a minute ago. The shortened version of the nine gamut is to only do the tapping on the hand and the eye circles. While there is merit in each step, the shortened version is helpful to soften a current emotional response or to wiggle loose something that got stuck but isn't a huge barrier in your session. Now that you know the steps, you can do it yourself with Dawson. Below is a linked video where he explains a bit more about the research on the nine gamut, and starting at 4 minutes and 14 seconds, he guides you on how to select an issue to use and takes you through the entire process. You get bonus points if you can figure out what song he's humming. I'll see you soon.